and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay. Now, I've just done, I've been kind of, as you know, been to Norfolk. I love Norfolk. I personally think it's quite possibly the greatest brewing county. And I know I'll upset a lot of people, but it's the second biggest brewing county after Yorkshire, I believe. I think it is, yeah. It's got over, well, there's 30-something breweries there, and there's more coming up all the time, and good ones. Pardon me. But I don't know if there's any kind of bad breweries in Norfolk. Not that I've noticed yet, anyway. Pardon me. Cool, that's gassy. I had that one. That was very, very nice. 3.8, so I was kind of, it was refined and delicate and lovely. But we're cracking heads. Cracking heads. That scared me, that did. Give me a headache as well. Head cracking. We're going to go do a bit of head cracking. 7%. So it's not massively head cracking, but, you know, it's on the way there. Very strong. Pal, or was it Paul? Pal Norfolk Owl. Right, I'm going to let you do your reading. And there you go. There you go. All nice, all good. Round the back, because we like it round the back. There we go. You got it? All good. Lovely. That's nice. Now, let's crash this open. So I'm kind of looking forward to this. I love a bit of head cracking. I don't do enough of it now, do I? Right, quite a soft crown there. Bend up quite easily. But it's all good, as long as it covers it and does its job. I'm not getting massive amounts off the bugle there, off the bottle, but then sometimes it waits until it gets into the open air before it starts doing stuff. I'm going to actually leave a little bit of room in this one. I know you, like, with bottle conditioned, you're not supposed to do that, but these are kind of quite clever with their bottle conditioning. They put a very minimum amount of yeast in there, if they put any in at all. Some of your brewers, they kind of rely on coming straight out of the fermentation tank, bottling up and kind of doing that quick while the yeast is still going woo woo woo, you know. Right, so up behind, there we go. You getting that? It's all pretty, lovely. Carbonation, nice and light and delicate, but enough to make you do plenty of burps if it's anything like the other one, the Wherry. It was exactly the same as that, all delicate. As you know, I don't pour head, blah, 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 because I don't like it. So there you go. Right. Cool, you can smell the alcohol. Right, a little trick here now. I often go for big, long kind of smells because I've got, a broken bugle and everything else has been this way, innit? Does that. It's not nice, is it? So kind of it's one way of getting it all through the tubes for me, but if you're ever having a bit of trouble smelling on your beers and things, there's two little tricks you can go for. One, put it to your mouth as if you're drinking it, and then like smell through there and through there at the same time. So it's like, just before you drink it, you know. That is a pretty good job of doing it. And also, if you're doing short, doggy type sniffs, you know, like that, it doesn't dry up your kind of receptors in your nose. They don't get dried up. They get a chance to kind of stay moist. If that makes any sense. Anyway, enough of that. I sound like a serious beer blogger otherwise, don't I? I don't want that mistake being made. Actually dip my lips in it. You're getting caramel, you're getting kind of a burnt sugar smell. Kind of like when you put your toffee apples in and you get burnt edges, you're getting that burnt sugar smell. And a kind of like a burnt toast as well. Right, let's have a dive in. You're getting a little bit of fruit as well, but more pith, more kind of something like the pith of like a not quite ripe orange when you scrape the pith off of that, you know, the zest. Oh, that is glorious. That is one of them drinks. Absolutely no correlation between the smells and the taste. Absolutely nothing. Yeah, on the smells, you're getting kind of like, you know, not a lot. And I don't know, I'm not sure what's there. And, you know, and you're kind of really digging deep to trying to find something. And then you have a taste and you go, oh, what's that? And there's all sorts in the taste, really all sorts of stuff going on. It's a big kind of banoffee pie sort of taste. Not overly banana-y, but like a banoffee pie. Oh, wow. You're getting a floral taste in there as well. Like a little bit of Earl Grey tea. And I'm diving in again. You got shortbread biscuits. You got a little bit of a Brazil nut. Oh, well. Oh, that's lovely. That is really lovely. You're getting almost like a shredded wheat sort of taste in there as well. Wow. That is mad. I love that. Cool, let's pour the rest in. Now, let's see if we are a little bit cloudy. I'm pouring the second lot in there. I think we may ever so slightly be, because the alcohol may have kind of helped to clear the bottom off. And yeah, we are ever so cloudy. Ever so slightly, I should say, not ever so. Look, just a little bit. Now that, see that? That can often give you different tastes, and it can often smooth things out. Pardon me. Makes a nicer mouthfeel quite often as well. And I love it. I love the way the light kind of seems to come from inside the drink when it's like that. Let me see if I can show you that. Where it just kind of the light disperses through it almost seems to come from inside the drink. There you go, look. It's almost like inside if you get different angles. You know, the light, whatever angle that comes in it, that light seems to kind of come from inside the drink in it. It's really, really gorgeous. And it seems to glow. Every bit of light it seems to pick up from the ambient lighting and that around or wherever. And it seems to glow in it when you've got a kind of slight hazing like that. That's beautiful. And to me, it just says of all richness and everything. Anyway, with the yeast in, or with a bit of it. Even better. Even better, you kind of... You're getting a more bready note, a big, oh wow, big, hefty, fresh, hunky bread. You know, go down to the Woods Creek, see, when being at school and things like that, you know, you're not too kind of clever about, yeah, looking after your own welfare and everything else and God knows what. So a lot of the time you'd all pull your dinner money together, you'd get buns and things. And one of the things we used to like to get between us was a loaf of bread and just kind of, that's fresh baked. Pardon me. So you're not getting all your vegetables and all this and that, but we was getting the energy from the bread and the buns and everything else, you know, so we was alright, you know. But we used to all pull our money together, go down the bakery and get whatever, you know, and have a good fill out, you know. And one of the things that was so lovely was the fresh baked loaf of bread. You get a big loaf of seedy bread, break it all open and start digging the insides out first. You'd have the crust after, be all digging bits of inside out. Oh, lovely. And while it's still lovely and warm. And it's like that, lovely and warm, kind of fresh bread. Absolutely beautiful. Oh, well, I like that. I've done very well for beers lately, I really have. I've been getting some real beauties. And that is another one. Real beauty, that's lovely. That is lovely. What's that say? Alright. There you go. Ed Cracker, get cracking. Go and buy it. Buy it and try it. It's beautiful. Cheers. Thanks for watching. Touch glasses. You wanna do that, didn't you? Cheers, chin chin, bottoms up.